we wouldn't be doing our duty if we weren't incorporating technology in the 21st century as part of our curriculum. Educators are going to have to spend a long time thinking about the choice of device that we use to harness the power of AI and the possibilities that it's going to enable. The use of the Surface device in the classroom has totally changed the dynamics. We know as a school that it's important that students have access to technology. Our school is 500 years old and we want it to last another 500 years. 2.5 years ago that we rolled out Surface Pro devices to all of our senior school students, so from the ages of 11 to 18. So before the Surfaces, we had PC suites. Students could bring their own devices, but that was difficult to manage. The aim was to try and level the playing field, make sure everyone had the same device. As a school, we needed to think really carefully what we wanted from a device, and one of the key priorities was that students would be able to still handwrite and digital ink. It had to be light and portable and not too heavy, so that a really sort of young 11-year-old could carry it around all day. And it's a good touch screen. And again, we just kept going back to Surface. The fact that the Surface Pro device is so flexible, so it's 2-in-1, the kids can take the keyboard off when they need to, they can use the pen and lie it flat, they can have it up, they can use it as a laptop. We need the Surface to be a recording studio, we need it to be a camera, we need it to be a digital notebook, we need it to be the entry point to their digital resources. It's used before school, at lunchtime, after school. So the Surface in the hands of every child has meant that their learning really goes beyond that of the boundaries of the school. The initial deployment went really, really well. We worked with Microsoft to decide the best way and the quickest, most efficient way to do that. We used the autopilot technique and method, and the students at school just took to it so, so quickly. It's made us think about the setup of where the desks are. Do we need the teacher to always be at the front of the class, like that traditional class setup? We need to think about now that Surface is here in the classroom, the kids are using it in loads of different ways. We're 2.5 years in, so we're reviewing the digital tools that we're using. So that's really important that we take that time to evaluate and keep checking in with what our core values are and making sure that students are making progress. The second thing is how AI is going to impact on our students. It already is. So at the moment, our teachers and our administration staff have access and are using Copilot to create lesson resources, to create images. At the moment, our students, though, do benefit from narrow AI that is built into Teams assignments. One of the biggest benefits that the Surface device has brought to our teachers is similar to the students. It's that of organisation. They have access to all their students' work whenever they want it. They use the device to digitally ink and mark and grade work, which they really love to do, but that's very traditional. On top of that, they can now do video recordings, audio recordings to give really good, rich feedback. When it comes to safety and security, that is totally unnegotiable when it comes with working with children. And cybersecurity is incredibly important to organisations and businesses. Well, it's important to us, but actually safeguarding and the security of our students' data is equally as important. The impact of that going wrong, it can be a real human impact. What reassured us was the fact that when we looked at the Surface, the hardware, the firmware, the operating system is renowned for safety and security. I think students do really like using the Surface. On the one hand, they absolutely really value having access to their subject resources and they don't have to carry around a planner. They get notifications saying that it's needed. It really reflects the world that they're growing up in. They love the flexibility of being able to use lots of different media when they're sort of learning and revising, and they're just really developing those digital skills of communication and collaboration, which again are needed when they're going to leave school. Parents have also been positive. They like that it fits into their lives really easily. It's not too big. It's taken away the choice that they have to go through when they're trying to decide to buy a computer for their student. The RGS Newcastle has always provided high quality education for the student. We see it just as another evolution of our provision to provide a laptop. We need our students and our future young people to know and understand information. They need to be really good learners. The future of learning at RGS is still going to be that of academic excellence, but it will now always incorporate technology as we move forward.